crisis in Syria can be resolved within months with the help of Russia. Nicolas Sarkozy thinks action is needed urgently to prevent Islamic State becoming entrenched. This comes as Russia says it sending its troops to the war zone could actually be an option, as Lizzie Phelan reports.
The Russian President Vladimir Putin's aide, Dmitry Peskov, has said that the Kremlin might consider sending soldiers to Syria to fight ISIL if it receives such a request from the Syrian government. But as of yet, there's nothing concrete in the pipeline. Now, at the moment, the U.S. coalition against ISIL includes over 60 nations, including Australia, which recently joined the bombing campaign, and France is considering doing the same. But on the other hand, the U.S. has blamed the Syrian government for allowing ISIL to gain ground in the country, and they say they don't want the help of the Syrian president Bashar al-Assad to fight against ISIL, calling him a criminal, the root of all evil, while also accusing Russia of escalating the conflict. Now, Moscow has denied that accusation and said that ISIL can only be defeated with Assad's forces. Let's have a listen to what Syria's envoy to the United Nations had to say on Thursday.
Why can the Americans fight ISIL with their warplanes and the Russians are forbidden from doing so? Does that make sense? It doesn't make sense. After all, we're fighting against one and the same enemy.
So as you can see, still a lot of divisions, but it looks as though the tide is starting to turn in terms of the international community's recognition of the Syrian government's central role in the fight against ISIL.